These are our split squats. They are a strength move for the legs. They're gonna be working your quads, your glutes, your hamstrings, your calves. They're almost a total leg strength move. Sometimes you'll see these called stationary lunges because you're in the same position you would be in a normal lunge. However, you're gonna be holding that position and working all on one leg at a time before switching to that other leg. So positioning for this one, very important. It's also the most common error I see is not getting into a good starting point for the split squat. I'm gonna start by stepping back with my right leg. You can start on whichever leg you want unless it specifically says in that workout to start on that right or that left leg. So you're gonna step on back, and the distance you step back is kind of the key here for our setup in our split squats. We wanna make sure, just like if you watched any of our lunge demonstration videos, you wanna make sure that at the bottom of that lunge, we're getting fairly close to kind of a 90 degree bend in each leg. So I'm gonna step on back. I'll show you a couple different positions. I'll step on back, get down nice and low, and we'll kind of examine. So I'm getting down nice and low in here and look at my legs. I'm somewhat close to a 90 degree bend, but I'm not quite there yet. I have about 2 inches or so in front of my front heel. This will probably be okay, but I'm gonna put a little bit more strain on my knees doing it this way. I'll step back again and show you again. Now when I come on down, I kind of went the opposite direction to the other extreme. I don't quite have a 90 degree bend in my front leg either. Back leg is all right. What's gonna happen here if my stance is too far out? I'm gonna feel a little bit more of a stretch in kind of my hips here when I step back in here. And I might overstretch them if I'm using weight on this exercise. So this is gonna be not a great position either for these. I'm gonna try one more time. Step on back, drop on down. Now I'm feeling pretty close to a 90 degree bend. I'm not feeling like an overstretch in my hips as I'm coming down into that low portion here. I'm not feeling a whole lot of pressure in my knee. If I look down at both legs, I have about a 90 and about a 90 here. And typically my back knee is about 8 to 10 inches or so from that front heel. This is gonna be my position I wanna get in and I wanna stay in. So once I find that position, I'm gonna get in that position, keep my torso nice and upright here. That way I'm dividing my weight in between my legs. If I wanted to focus more on that front leg, I would lean over a little bit more throughout this movement. But I'm gonna stay nice and upright here, dropping straight down and straight up throughout that split squat. I can do these with just body weight, or I can hold a dumbbell against my chest. I can hold dumbbells at my sides. I can have weights on my shoulders. I can have a bar up here. I can have a sandbell or a kettlebell. You can pretty much add any weight into this movement to make it more challenging, but I always want you to start until you get comfortable with the movement with just those body weight going through it without any added weight. So common mistakes, like I said, the most common mistake is going to be foot positioning either too far out or too close together. So really look down at your legs, find that spot. Once you have done this exercise, continually each time, making sure that you have that correct position, you'll start to remember, and without even thinking about it, you'll step to almost the exact position that you're gonna wanna be every single time. It's gonna take doing it a few times first before that muscle memory will come into play there. So that's the main thing. The other thing is not keeping a good posture. So remember I said to divide that weight, I wanna keep nice and upright, dropping on down and up. A lot of times I'll see people collapse over their front foot. Like I said, if you're wanting to pinpoint just that front leg, you do want to have a little bit more of a forward lean. However, typically we want to divide that weight. Last common mistake I see made in this exercise is not keeping that front foot flat on the floor and dropping straight down into this movement. I see a lot of people kind of rock forward, dropping that front foot kind of up onto the toes, and that movement in that body is coming forward and back. Throughout that split squat movement, we want straight down and straight up. So get in that movement, straight down and straight up here. That way I'm engaging my glute and my hamstring in that leg. I'm not just working my quad. This is a total leg exercise. So focus on that posture. Focus on the distance for your feet here. Make sure you get everything dialed in and comfortable with that movement, and then start ramping up that weight and working on your strength.